Originally, the Lodeline name theme was used by the Yorkshire Steam Fishing Company of Hull in the 1900s. Two examples of these ships were the Lord Lister and the Lord Salisbury. In the 1920s, the Yorkshire Fishing Company was amalgamated with Pickering and Haldanes. After this time, Pickering and Haldanes adopted the Lodeline name theme and Yorkshires were given the suffix flower, i.e. beer flower. By 1939, the Pickering and Haldanes fleet consisted of 28 modern trawlers. With the outbreak of World War II, all these vessels were requisitioned for use as minesweepers and anti-submarine patrol vessels. The Hull Fish Dock was closed and the workforce went into the services. Then in 1941, the Pickering and Haldanes offices were destroyed by a landmine. This blow, combined with the losses of the trawlers due to enemy action, led to the company being sold in 1944 and a new company named Lodeline was formed. After the war, the company received back surviving trawlers of the pre-war fleet. From 1947, a big shipbuilding program was begun, and once again, Lodeline became one of Hull's premier trawling owning companies. In 1950, the company passed to Associated Fisheries, whose main shareholders were the Bennett family of London. The company operated out of the new Lodeline building on St Andrew's Dock. The manager was Tom Boyd, who also managed his own family's company, Boydline. Around this time, Associated Fisheries took over Northern Trawlers of Grimsby and built up the fleets with sister ships to those at Lodeline. As time went by, Associated Fisheries expanded, taking over many old established companies. In 1963, Hellyer Brothers amalgamated with Associated Fisheries. In the resulting reorganisation, 10 top-class trawlers of the Lodeline fleet were transferred to Northern Trawlers Grimsby. The older trawlers of the fleet were transferred to Wyre Trawlers at Fleetwood. In 1966, the last 5 sidewinders and the stern trawler Lord Nelson passed into the Hellyer fleet, bringing to an end the Lodeline era. One of the trawlers which was transferred from Hull to Grimsby was the Silver Cod winning trawler Lord Beatty. In 1970, Jim Calder took his cine camera to the Grimsby fish docks. The historic film he took gives us a good insight into the activities at Grimsby at this time. One of the major British trawler owners in 1970 was British United Trawlers Limited, of which Associated Fisheries was the major constituent. Trawlers on the North Wall. Steam trawler Everton, GY58, Britain's largest steam trawler, 884 tons gross, 1958, having a galley called up. motor trawler, Saxon Ranger, GY 1396, 286 tons gross, 1961. Saxon Trawlers Limited, Grimsby, a laid up. Motor trawler, Ross Fame, GY 1360, 457 tons gross, laid up. Ross Trawlers Limited, Grimsby. Motor trawler, Ross Intrepid, H353, 1,156 tons, 1966, laid up. Ross Freezer Trawlers Limited, Grimsby. Motor trawler, Northern Sun, GY2, 656 tons gross, 1956, laid up. X Wire Mariner, FD34. Motor trawler Victory, GY 733, 1,181 tons, 1965. Stern Fishing Freezer Trawler of Northern Trawlers Limited, Grimsby. Seen here unloading her catch of frozen fish. Sister ships Conqueror, GY 1364, Defiance, GY 1377. Motor trawler, Ross Zebra, GY 653, 352 tons gross, 1960. The only Cat class sidewinder which does not have a Cat name. Ross Trawlers Limited, Grimsby. Motor trawler, Boston Lincoln, GY 1399, built in Poland as a fresher in 1968. 846 tons gross, 212 feet in length. 1969, lengthened to 237.7 feet and converted to a freezer. Motor trawler, Lord Jellicoe, GY 709, 594 tons gross, 1962. Northern Trawlers Limited, Grimsby. Sister ships, Northern Reward, GY 694, Northern Gift, GY 704. Steam trawler, Vanessa, GY 257, 685 tons gross, 1952, having a refit. Northern Trawlers Limited, Grimsby, originally built for Atlas Steam Fishing Company Limited. Thank you. Steam Trawler Lord BT, GY91, 697 tons, 1956. Seen here on the slip for bottom clean and paints between trips. Fish Market Dock. Steam Trawler Lord Mount Evans, GY79, 712 tons gross, 1951, Northern Trawlers Limited, Grimsby. Lord Beatty taking on ice at the ice dock. Motor Trawler Orkino, GY689, 273 tons gross, 1962, Japan Fishing Company Limited, Grimsby, subsidiary of Diamonds Steam Fishing Company Limited, Grimsby, itself owned by Taylor Steam Fishing Company Limited. Trawler Northern Reward, GY694, 576 tons gross, 1962. Northern Trawlers Limited, Grimsby, leaving the ice berth for the North Wall, accompanied by motor tug. Sister ships, the Northern Gift, GY704 above, and Lord Jellicoe, GY709. Motor Trawler William Wilberforce, GY140, 698 tons, 1959, originally operated out of Hull as H200 until 1968, Parbell Smith, Aberdeen, subsidiary of Boston Deep Sea Fisheries Limited, Seen here landing at fish market. Motor trawler, Port Vale, GY484, 427 tons gross, 1957. First diesel trawler built for Consolidated Fisheries Limited, Grimsby. Steam trawler Hull City, GY248, 711 tons gross, 1953. Steam trawler Grimsby Town, GY246, 711 tons gross, 1953. Templecroft, Scarthorne Road, Grimsby, home of late Jack Butt, uncle of John Butt, Deepwater Manager of Northern Trawlers Limited, Grimsby, subsidiary of British United Trawlers Limited. On Jack Butt's death, the house became an old people's home. Jack Butt coming out to see Jim Calder off on his trip. Steam trawler Lord Beatty, details and history. Built in 1956 at Rickmers Verft, Bremerhaven, for Lord Line Hull as H112. Official number 186696. 697 gross tons. Length 189.5 feet. Overall, beam 31 foot 8 inches, maximum draft 17 foot 1 inch. Fitted with enclosed triple expansion engine with Bure VAC exhaust turbine, double reduction geared and hydraulic coupling to single screw. Total IHP 1400, giving a service speed of 14 knots. Superheated steam supplied at 225 psi and temperature 585 degrees Fahrenheit by oil fired boiler. Fuel consumption approximately 9.5 tons per day. Fuel capacity 300 tons. Machinery and boiler manufactured by Ottensener Eisenwerk, Hamburg. Sister ship Northern Eagle, GY22, official number 184937, 701 tons gross, 1956. Most powerful steam trawlers in British fishing industry. Near Sisters, Coldstreamer GY10, official number 184929, 697 tons gross, 1955. The Royal Lynx GY18, official number 184930, 697 tons gross, 1955. Black Watch GY23, official number 184941, 697 tons gross, 1956.
first time I went on board the BT in 1972, and to my eye, she was vast, she was big, and I thought, you know, looking at her when I stepped aboard, I thought, well, this is going to be a bloody unwieldy lot, this. But when we left the dock down the river, got into the open sea, she handled like a motor car. I mean, the little steering wheel on the bridge, there's none of the old spoke wheels or anything like that. And she's a fantastic ship to steer or for maneuverability. I don't know what she was going to behave like once we got the gear down, but she took everything in her stride. And much as I hate to say it, the Germans know how to build bloody ships.
Motor dredger Cherry Sand, 1,080 tons gross, 1968, British Transport Docks Board, Grimsby, heading into the Grimsby Docks. Motor vessel Sugar Importer, 11,687 tons gross, 1959. Ex Athol Prince, 1966. In ballast, outward bound from the Humber. Tait and Lyle Shipping Limited. Steam trawler Northern Jewel, off to Iceland. Danish roll-on, roll-off motor vessel, Surrey, 3,374 tons, 1969.